Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest is a PR marketing guru, philanthropist, and now author.
She's here with a message of overcoming obstacles and living your best life. Please welcome Arian Simone.
Yay! Yay! Girl, how are you doing? You look amazing.
I am excellent. Thank you.
And this hair coming out your scalp. Tell the people how this is all her hair, honey, from the rooter to the tooter. Okay, then. So, Arian, the last time you were here, you talked about, you know, your glow up of coming from living out of your car and to just really increasing and progressing in your crafts. How is it going now? What are you doing now? How are you feeling now? And how have you been able to keep yourself going?
Oh my gosh, I am feeling excellent. Yeah. I am a best-selling author. My book is number one
on
Amazon right now.
Come on! Yes.
So I am doing wonderful. The book is called Fearless Faith and Hustle, and it's pretty much about my journey and how I've aligned my faith with my hustle and how it takes both in order to succeed.
That's good.
And you're also a successful PR rep. I mean, you've worked with Lil Wayne. You've also worked with Walt Disney and Sony. How did that come about?
Oh my gosh. I will share just, the Cliff Note version. Uh-huh. Pretty much, after school, I was just figuring out life, and I was sought out to do some PR and marketing work. Yeah. And when the door opened, I didn't just walk through it, I ran through it.
Come on.
And I built a PR and marketing firm from the ground up. And we've serviced many, many films, from Ride Along to Takers to Will Smith's Hancock to Robert De Niro's Limitless, and the list goes on and on. So, yeah.
Wow. And so, no, go ahead.
I just can't help it. Are you sometimes shocked at your success?
Yeah, I'm always amazed by what God does in my life.
How good he is.
I am.
You better say that, girl.
I'm always amazed.
And he's even better, because in 2010, you released a magazine called Fearless Magazine. What was the inspiration behind that magazine?
My journey. Mm-hmm. My journey, pretty much just figuring out life and seeing that being fearless was an ingredient to my success. I put out the publication, and we were nationally distributed. Barnes & Noble's Borders was open at the time. Mm-hmm. Had cover girls from Lala Anthony to Khloe Kardashian to Kelly Rowland and more.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
And over time, it just pretty much evolved from the magazine into an empowerment movement.
Right.
We ended up with so many women in the community that were just in love with the content and being inspired and educated that we just continued on, and we host conferences and events and things of that nature.
And you're still doing that now?
Correct.
Yes, absolutely.
Oh, I love that. Mm-hmm. And women, we definitely need that. We need to inspire each other and motivate each other and encourage one another. Mm-hmm. Often we don't do that, you know,
but
we're getting better.
I personally think we're getting better at
that. And people are waking up to actually loving each other and loving themselves.
Mm-hmm.
But now 2019, like you said, you have just taken off. Your book is number one right now on Amazon. It's called Fearless Faith and Hustle.
Yes.
And you've made that a devotional.
Correct. Because so many people would always ask me, what is your morning routine? And I'm like, oh my gosh, my morning routine is I'm in a devotional every morning. Mm-hmm. And I was like, let me be able to package this and give them my morning routine. So in the book, there's prayers, there's scriptures, there's meditation, there's exercises, there's declarations, and even inspirational journeys of other female entrepreneurs. So I made it a devotional for the female entrepreneur, having her in mind. Because I understand that that role can be just so many ups and downs.
Absolutely.
That you want to definitely just stay grounded in your faith through the process. Mm-hmm. So that's pretty much why. And I did it for 21 days, so that it's easy to digest.
Twenty-one days
to make a habit. Therefore, people can just have just a little bit a day, a little bit a day, a little bit a day, and get through the journey of it.
Absolutely, that's good.
It really is.
It really is. Yeah. Okay, so we would be remiss if we didn't ask you to take us through some of these tips in your book, so that we can at least get a good start.
Got you. Yeah. So the first one I want to talk to you guys about is giving God room to perform miracles.
Hello, somebody.
So often we'll have our hands just so tight on something, just trying to control something, just trying to control the outcome. Mm-hmm. But if we're doing that, then what's the purpose of having faith?
Mm-hmm. Well, you know what?
You know, so you want to make sure that you leave room for God to perform miracles.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
The next principle I want to talk to you guys about is seizing the moment.
Mm-hmm.
Because the reality is a moment can never be relived.
Mm-hmm.
So if you don't seize that moment, you're going to miss that moment.
Mm-hmm.
So I would have missed the moment of being here if I didn't get my butt on a plane to get back in town.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to seize those moments and those opportunities.
Mm-hmm.
And the third one I want to talk to you guys about, which I want to say is like day 20 in the book, which is about having purpose over popularity. And the reason why.
Oh, now that's real good.
Yes.
Say that again.
Purpose over popularity. hilarious. Because there was a day, like back in the day, when Rosa Parks was just as VIP as Aretha Franklin, where if somebody was doing impact, it was just as much as a VIP as somebody doing entertainment.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Because it was all about purpose, it was all about substance. Mm-hmm. And due to social media and just things that have taken place now, people are just so caught up with being famous.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Well, no, God created you for a reason to be in this earth, and He has an assignment for you. Mm-hmm. So you don't want to veer from whatever that assignment is. Your assignment will make you popular, honestly.
Hello, absolutely. Somebody.
But you just need to just stay focused on what that is.
Just like Colin Kaepernick. Hello, somebody.
That is true.
That is so true.
And talk to us about your foundation, the Fearless Foundation. Yes. Talk to us about that. I think it has something to do with homelessness.
Yes, most definitely. We provide rehabilitative aid and financial aid to female shelters.
Yes.
Mm. And we also supply them with different materials to educate them about non-traditional careers, to pretty much help them get back on life, you know, get back on track with life and go out there and live their best lives. So,
that's good. Because I think people forget about people that are homeless. I think generally, not everybody, but I think that there are so many things that we need to pay attention to that a lot of times we forget about the homeless.
And honestly, in America, we have.
Yeah.
We definitely have. I was in Cuba recently, and they said to us, we're a poor country. You guys are a rich country. But yet we're third world, and we don't have people on the street.
My God. Wow. Arian, thank you so much for joining us today. Be sure to connect. Well, pick up her copy of her book,
Fearless Faith and Hustle.
Fearless Faith and Hustle, where all fine books are sold. Absolutely.